Welcome back to Market Headlines. The sluggish economy due to COVID-19 pandemic has not discouraged companies for conducting an initial public offering or IPO on Indonesia Stock Exchange. This can be seen from 40 companies that have conducted IPOs until early September of 2020.
The sluggish economy due to the COVID-19 pandemic has not discouraged companies from conducting an initial public offering or IPO on the Indonesia Stock Exchange. The latest data shows that until early September 2020, 40 companies had successfully conducted IPOs. The Indonesia Stock Exchange admits that the interest of companies that wish to list their shares is still high. The high interest of companies to take the floor on the ITX can't be separated from the need for funding, which is an alternative source of fundraising apart from banking. At the same time, the Indonesia Stock Exchange strives to ensure that companies that go public are of good quality. In the midst of high interest in IPO, the Indonesian Capital Market Authorities, ITX, and Financial Services Authority, or OJK, stated that they are not only concerned with quantity, but also quality. The selection and inspection process is carried out jointly with the authorities at an early stage in both the primary and the secondary markets. From all sources, for IDX Channel.
And yes, viewers, as an alternative in funding, new sources of funding, IPO in capital market have become the main choice for many companies. And this is no exceptions in the midst of the harsh conditions like today, where the COVID-19 pandemic is pressing all economic sectors. And however, it has been noted that up to now, the company's interest in conducting IPO is still quite high. How is the data so far? So let's get into the first graphic, shall we? Through your screen, we can see that the number of companies that conducting IPO since 2017 to 2020. Here it is through the data, we can see that in 2017, there were 37 companies that conducted IPO, but the number went significantly, jumped to 57 companies in 2018, while in 2019, it decreased only a bit, by 55 companies that conducted IPO so far in 2019. And here it is in 2020, up until now, there are 40 companies that conducting IPO. And the closer to the end of September, the more companies listed their shares on the Indonesia Stock Exchange. And regarding this, Indonesia Stock Exchange said that the number of potential listed companies were pursuing listing of shares before the end of the third quarter of 2020, because the company used the first quarter financial statements as the database in the public offering, so the IPO process had to be completed as soon as possible. And meanwhile, even though the number of companies that have conducted IPO is approaching the positions of the end of 2019 in terms of value, it is still quite far, where in 2019, the total IPO value reached 14.78 trillion rupiah, even higher in 2018 of 15.67 trillion rupiah. So which companies that have conducted IPO so far? Let's move on to the next graphic. Here it is through your screen, we can see the graphic on the latest listed companies on IDX. Here it is, we can see Selaras, Citra Nusantara Perkasa, and moving on to BAM Business International, and of course, Kunia Mitra Duta Sentosa. And these three companies has officially become the 38th, 39th, and 40th listed companies on Indonesia Stock Exchange in 2020. And regarding IPO, newcomer shares tends to experience a significant increase in price on the first day of trading in Indonesia Stock Exchange, including these three companies, where ACNP went up by 34.55%, BBSI that went up 25%, and KMDS that increased by 24.67%. And although many parties say that the price increase on the first day of trading tended to only last for a moment, at the same time, the Indonesia Stock Exchange stated that many IPO companies then continued to upward trend which was supported by good company fundamentals. And apart from these three companies, let's take a look at the other companies that just helped officially become a part of GCI today. Let's see through the next graphic. Through the next graphic, we can see the latest listed company on IDX that has a listing date on September 8, 2020. Here it is. We got Soho Global Health and Puri Global Success. And for your information, Soho Global Health stated that the IPO is a strategic step for the company to strengthen its positions in the pharmaceutical and health sector in Indonesia. And the company revealed that all proceeds from the IPO will be used to strengthen the distribution's business. And meanwhile, the other issuer in here through your screen, we can see we have also Puri Global Success, or Puri, stated that the proceeds from the IPO will be used to increase equity participations in the subsidiary to increase the land banks. And again, viewers, the increase in price was also felt by these two newest issuers, whereas Soho rose by 24% at the opening of trading, and Puri jumped very high to 34%. But once again, don't be just tempted by the potential for the high price increases. Investors still have to pay close attention to the fundamental conditions of the IPO companies. And yes, viewers, how many companies there are still in the queue for the IPO? Let's take a look in the next graphic. Through your screen, we can see the IPO queue on Indonesian Stock Exchange as of August 31st, 2020. Here it is. We got a bunch of companies, four companies in the property, real estate, and building constructions. Well, two other companies in trade and service and investment sectors, two more companies in machinery industry, two more companies in consumer goods, and one company in the finance sector. And here it is, in the midst of high interest in IPO, the Indonesian Capital Market Authorities, IDX, and the Financial Services Authority, or OJK, stated that they are not only concerned with the quantity, but also with quality. The selections and inspections processed are carried out together as the early stage in both in primary and secondary markets. And in addition, Indonesia Stock Exchange strive to ensure that the company that go public are in the good quality. And by looking at the data, hopefully it shows that all stakeholders in the capital market are still optimistic despite the pandemic hits Indonesia. And therefore, viewers, stay tuned for market headlines, because we will be right back after this quick break.